Okay, so now put the rate, page number 38 and third para. Date written?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, on the seventh day after that, two things happened. This is very important, a question may come. What happened on the seventh day? In the morning, the servants left together their belongings tied in a large square cotton kerchiefs. When Hannah got up in the morning, nothing was done. The house was not clean and the food not prepared, and she knew what it meant. Now, what happened on the seventh day? Okay, two things happened. First one, in the morning, the servants, they left the job. Their belongings tied in a large square cotton kerchiefs, you know, like a pottery, they tied all their belongings. And when Hannah, you know, she got up in the morning, she saw that no work was done. No cleaning, no cooking, nothing. And she understood, you know, that servants, they have decided to leave the job and that is why no work has been done. She was dismayed and even terrified, but her pride as a mistress would not allow her to show it. Now she was dismayed, she was somewhat sad, you know, and at the same time terrified, afraid also. Why said? Because the servants, they had been working there since a long time. They were like family members. They were leaving. And next thing, she was terrified. She was scared that now they will go out and they will report against them to the police. And then they would be in trouble. Dr. Sadao and the family would be in trouble. Okay. But, you know, she would not let her down. She did not show such feelings to them. Why? Because a pride as a mistress, you know, that did not allow her to show such feelings, such weak feelings that she had. Instead, she inclined her head gracefully, inclined, you know, bent her head gracefully when they appeared before her in the kitchen, and she paid them off and thanked them for all that they had done for her. And when she was there in the kitchen, all the servants had come. They said that they are leaving. She did not try to stop them. She did not show any signs of sadness or any signs of fear. Okay. She just bent her head a little, very gracefully, paid them the money, okay, their salaries and everything, and also thanked them for the services that they had given to Dr. Sadao and his family. They were crying, but she did not cry. See now. The servants, you know, they were crying. Why? Because they were very much attached to this family. Okay, to Dr. Sadao, Hannah and the children. But she did not cry. The cook and the gardener had served Sadao since he was a little boy in his father's house. I told you, ki jo gardener aur cook the, wo to bachpan se, jab bahut saalon se Dr. Sadao bahut chote the na, beta, jab se they had been serving in the house. And Yumi, she cried because of the children. Now, Yumi was very much attached to the children. You know, she was the caretaker nanny of the children. She was so grieving that after she had gone, she ran back to Hannah. And she cried so much that once she left the house, but again she ran back and she came to Hannah. Hannah ko aakar kya kehti, if the baby misses me too much tonight, send for me. I'm going to my own house. And you know where it is. You know, kehti, if the baby, you know, he misses me, why? बिकॉज शुरू से ही वो बच्चा यूमी के पास रहता था तो कहते बेबी मिस करे मुझे तो जस्ट कॉल मी हाना को कहती है और कहती यू नो माई हाउस वेरी वेल ओके थैंक यू हाना कह देती है उसको सेट स्माइलिंग बट शी टोल्ड हर्सेल्फ शी वुड नॉट सेंड फॉर यूमी हाउ एवर द बेबी बट हाना अगेन एज द प्राइड ऑफ अ मिस्ट्रेस यू नो सो ही शी कैप्ट द प्राइड ऑफ अ मिस्ट्रेस एंड शी डिसाइड्स ऑन हर ओन कि Even if the baby cries, she is not going to call Yumi. She made the breakfast. Sadao helped with the children. Neither of them spoke of the servants beyond the fact that they were gone. Now, she did the household work and Sadao, he took care of the children. And they did not have any discussion on the servants. Okay, only this thing was there between them. Yes, the servants left the job and had gone. Bas itni baat hui thi. But after Hannah had taken morning food to the prisoner, she came back to Sadao. Okay, मॉर्निंग फूड के बाद शी कम्स बैक टू सदाओ एंड शी सेज व्हाई इज इट वी कैन नॉट सी क्लियरली व्हाट वी ऑट टू डू शी आस्क्स हिम इवन द सर्वेंट सी मोर क्लियरली देन वी डू व्हाई आर वी डिफरेंट फ्रॉम अदर जापानीज शी कम्स एंड शी पुट्स अप अ क्वेश्चन टू डॉक्टर सदाओ कि व्हाई इज इट सो दैट वी आर नॉट एबल टू सी okay we are not able to decide what is to be done with this prisoner of war why are we not able to see a future okay future means the time that is about to come because they have sheltered a prisoner of war that was the main reason ki hum kyun nahi dekh pate hain ki what are we supposed to do what are we going to do with this prisoner even the servants see more clearly than we do even the servants you know they are trying to keep themselves safe they can see the future ki in case if they are going to stay here in sadao's house they would be in trouble so unhone sab dekh liya tha aage ka isliye they left the job and they had gone though they did not have any intention of leaving but still they left it and they had gone okay so if they can decide then why can't we hana she puts up a question to dr sadao and she says why are we different from other japanese followed beta
yes ma'am
yes okay. ma'am
sadao did not answer but a little later he went into the room where the prisoner was and said briskly today you may get up on your feet I want you to stay up only 5 minutes at a time tomorrow you may try it twice as long it would be well that you get back your strength as quickly as possible but sadao you know he did not answer hana but he decides something on his own okay he goes to the room of the american prisoner he directs him he tells him that today you are going to stand on your feet okay and that too only for 5 minutes tomorrow you can just double the time 10 minutes and so on keep on increasing until you get back your strength okay and it would be fine if you get back your strength means it would be fine if you are okay if you are fine as soon as possible if you are fit ab jaise hi bolta hai ki tum jaldi se jaldi theek ho jao that would be better he saw the flicker of terror on the young man's face that was still very pale now as he says this dr sadao notices a flicker you know a glimpse of terror okay a sign of terror kahi uski aankhon mein ek jhalak dikh jati hai dar ki dehshat ki kiski aankhon mein prisoner ki aankhon mein okay the boy murmurs okay murmuring is the soft sound which springs out okay fine evidently he was determined to say more and it looked it was very clear ki he wanted to speak more and he says I feel I ought to thank you doctor for having saved my life he says that I feel it's my duty to thank you doctor as you have saved my life don't thank me too early now sadao turan jawab deta hai don't thank me too early okay it is too early you are thanking me okay don't be so fast in thanking me जैसे वो कहता है कि इतनी जल्दी थैंक मत करो कहीं ना कहीं टेरर यू नो इट डेवलप्स इन द हार्ट ऑफ प्रिजनर कि ही इज नॉट रेडी टू एक्सेप्ट माय थैंक्स ही वांट्स मी टू बी फिट ओके ही वांट्स मी टू बी स्ट्रॉन्गर सो दैट आई मे स्टैंड ऑन माय फीट आई मे बी फाइन तो इट मींस ही इज गोइंग टू टेक सम एक्शन अगेंस्ट मी ओके तो ये सोचकर अगेन अ फ्लिकर ऑफ टेरर कुड बी सीन इन द बॉयज आईज terror as unmistakable as an animal's as you see terror okay in an animal's eyes okay when you proceed towards an animal when you proceed towards an animal do you see a flicker of terror why because animals you know they are very much afraid of human beings unko lagta hai the man is proceeding towards me surely he is going to harm me isn't it you proceed towards an animal that animal you know he might run away or he might try to back himself and you can see a terror in its eyes hai na uski aankhon mein dar dikhta hai kyun usko malum hai ki usko ye aabhas hota hai ki koi na koi nuksan karega to isi tarah se hue flicker of terror was there in the american's eyes as he knew very well maybe he might have understood ki as soon as I'm fine this man this doctor he is going to take some action against me maybe he might hand me over to the police or whatsoever the scars on his neck were crimson crimson means red for a moment those scars what were they sadao did not ask Now Sadhav sees, as he sees terror in his eyes, he saw the scars, the scratches that were there on his neck, they had become red. And Sadhav thinks ki ye scars kiske hain, he wanted to ask, but he did not ask. In the afternoon, the second thing happened. First thing, you got it, the servants left. Right, children?
Yes, ma'am.
And which day was it?
Ma'am, seventh day.
Seventh day, okay, right. So in the afternoon, the second thing happened. Hannah, working hard on uncustomed labor, saw a messenger come to the door in official uniform. Now Hannah, she saw, now working hard, she worked very hard on uncustomed labor. Uncustomed matlab, not in the habit of, okay? She was not habitual of doing the household work, as all the work was done by the servants, right? So she was unaccustomed, right? Somewhat tired also. And in the afternoon, she saw a messenger had come to the door. And the messenger, he was wearing the official uniform, okay? Maybe the police or the general might have sent him. Her hands went weak and she could not draw her breath. See, imagine if a policeman comes and stands on your doorway, what will happen? You'll start shivering, na, ki what happened? Something has gone wrong, right? Even she felt very weak and she could not breathe properly. The servant must have told already, ab usko to surety di ki servants, they had left the house and they have gone and complained against them. She ran to Sadhav, gasping, means breathing hardly, you know, panting, unable to utter a word. Now, she wanted to reach Sadhav and tell him that a messenger had come. But as she reaches and as she was about to tell Dr. Sadhav, she could not inform him about the messenger. But by then, the messenger had simply followed her through the garden and there he stood. क्यों नहीं बोल सकी क्योंकि जब तक मैसेंजर जो है ऑलरेडी गार्डन में आ चुका था एंड ही वाज स्टैंडिंग नेक्स्ट टू हना शी पॉइंटेड एट हिम हेल्पलेसली हना डिड नॉट हैव एनी ऑप्शन और बड़ी हेल्पलेस होके शी पॉइंटेड टुवर्ड्स डॉक्टर सदाव्स ऑफिस वेयर डॉक्टर सदाव वाज सिटिंग Sadhav looked up from his book. Now Sadhav might be reading some book or something. He was in his office. The other partition means door, which was thrown open to the garden for the southern sunshine. Okay. Now he was sitting in his office and the other door, there were two doors in the room. Okay. One it opened inside the house and one it opened towards the garden. To the garden ki taraf tha, it was open. What is it? He asked the messenger and then he rose seeing the man's uniform. पहले तो उसने बैठे बैठे पूछ लिया क्या है फिर जैसे ही messenger को देखा है in the uniform he just stood up. You are to come to the palace, the man said. The old general is in pain. Okay. अब messenger ने message दे दिया कि you are supposed to come to the palace. Why? Because the old general, he is suffering from pain. Oh, Hannah Brad, is that all? All the messenger exclaimed. Ab Hannah ne lambi saans li. Oh, is it enough? Only this is the message she wanted to say. Okay. All, ab wo kuch samajh nahi paya. Is it not enough? Yeah, enough nahi hai. Indeed it is. She replied, ha, kehti, sure it is. Okay, enough. You know, I'm very sorry. Sometimes it happens, beta, ki so many times you're scared of something. You're very much afraid, hai na, bahut dare hue hote ho, and the reverse, it happens, okay? Uska ulta ho jata hai. To yahan par bhi aise hi kuch hua. When Sadhav came to say goodbye, she was in the kitchen, but she was doing nothing. Kitchen mein thi, kuch nahi kar rahi thi. The children were asleep, and she sat merely resting for a moment. Bacche so gaye the, and she was just resting. More exhausted, more tired from her fright than from her work. More tired from her fright, from her fear, okay? ठीक है, from this panic, ये जो घबराहट उसको हुई थी, okay, जो डर था messenger का, उससे ज्यादा थकान हो रही थी than from domestic work, okay? घर के काम से ज्यादा वो उसकी वजह से काफी weak feel कर रही थी. I thought they had come to arrest you, or उसने अपना doubt clarify करी थी, उसे लगा डॉक्टर सदाव को कहती है मुझे लगा कि दे हैड कम टू अरेस्ट यू. He gazed down into her anxious eye. Now Sadao looked into her anxious, worried eyes. I must get rid of this man for your sake, he said in distress. I'm going to get rid of this man, especially for you, he says to his wife. Somehow I must get rid of him. Anyhow, kuch bhi ho, now I'm going to get rid of this. Followed?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. Now Sadao goes to see the general. Now when he goes to see the general, beta, he just tells the general everything about this prisoner. Okay, he never hides anything from him, and at this time also he doesn't hide anything from general. And why? Because general, you know, he had lot of trust in Dr. Sadao. He knew Dr. Sadao. He was a very hardworking and a very honest doctor. Okay, so he trusted him a lot. So the Dr. Sadao ko wo sab kuch bata deta. Of course, I understand fully, but that is because I once took a degree in Princeton. So please definitely have. Kehta main samajh sakta hu ki bhai ye sentiment feelings kyun hai. Even मैंने भी प्रिंसटन में डिग्री ली थी, लेकिन फ्यू जैपनीज की डिग्रीज हैं वहां की. आई केयर नथिंग फॉर द मैन एक्सीलेंसी. नाउ दिस मैन वन नाउ डॉक्टर सदाव ही सेज आई डोंट केयर फॉर दिस मैन बट हैविंग ऑपरेटेड ऑन हिम विद सच सक्सेस. लेकिन ही सेज कि आई हैव ऑपरेटेड हिम सक्सेसफुली, माय ऑपरेशन हैड बीन सक्सेसफुल, ओके, एंड देन आई हैड सेव्ड हिम, देन हाउ कैन आई जस्ट हैंड हिम ओवर टू द पुलिस, और हाउ कैन आई लेट हिम डाई एंड सो ऑन. यस यस द जनरल सेड, इट ओनली मेक्स मी फील यू मोर इंडिस्पेंसेबल टू मी. एविडेंटली यू कैन सेव एनीवन, यू आर सो स्किल्ड. ओके, अच्छा यही बातें फील करा रही है कि यू आर वेरी नेसेसरी टू मी. तुम इतने स्किल्ड हो, कि इतने टैलेंटेड हो, अपने काम में इतने स्किल्ड हो, इतने निपुण हो कि यू कैन सेव सो परफेक्ट दैट यू कैन सेव एनीबॉडीज लाइफ. ओके, एनीबॉडीज विदाउट थिंकिंग अबाउट हिज नेशनलिटी, रिलीजन, रेस, क्रीड, व्हाटएवर. यू से यू थिंक आई कैन स्टैंड वन मोर सच अटैक एज आई हैव हैड ऑलरेडी टुडे. ओके, और तुम्हारा ये कहना है कि वन मोर अटैक I can, okay, stand. I can tolerate one more heart attack. You know that day, जब ये बात करने जाता है, general was in pain. He had a heart attack, but doctor Sadao saved him. लेकिन doctor Sadao कहता है कि अब एक और heart attack आए तो भी आप बच सकते हो. You were so this thing, okay? तो वो कहता है कि तुमने मुझे कहा कि one more attack I can bear. Not more than one. तो डॉक्टर सदाव क्लैरिफाई कर देते हैं कि इतना ओवर कॉन्फिडेंट भी नहीं होना कि नॉट मोर देन वन. तो वो कहता है देन सडनली, मतलब he was so much trusted this डॉक्टर सदाव by the general कि general कहता है कि अभी भी इसको इतना कॉन्फिडेंस है कि still if one more attacks come to me I can be saved. One more attacks if I suffer from I could be saved by this doctor. इतना ज्यादा trust है. तो वो कहता है देन श्योरली इवन आई कैन नॉट अलाउ एनीथिंग टू हैपन टू यू इफ यू आर सो कंसर्न्ड अबाउट माय लाइफ. इवन आई एम वेरी मच कंसर्न्ड अबाउट योर लाइफ. हु सेज जनरली, ओके, ही सेज अप टू डॉक्टर सदाव. सो ही सेज सडनली आई कैन अलाउ नथिंग टू हैपन टू यू द जनरल सेड विद एंग्जायटी. हिज लॉन्ग पेल जैपनीज फेस बिकेम एक्सप्रेशनलेस व्हिच मेंट दैट ही वाज इन डीप थॉट. और एक्सप्रेशन लेस हो गया, इसका मतलब वो कुछ गहरी सोच में है. और सोचने के बाद वो डिसाइड करके कहता है यू कैन नॉट बी अरेस्टेड. जनरल कहता है सपोज यू वर कंडेम्ड टू डेथ एंड द नेक्स्ट डे आई हैड टू हैव माय ऑपरेशन. सी नाउ ही इज समवट वी कैन से बेटा ही इज सेल्फिश एंड दैट इज द मेन रीजन ही वॉन्ट्स टू सेव डॉक्टर सदाव. वाई? बिकॉज ही ट्रस्टेड ओनली एंड ओनली डॉक्टर सदाव. सिंस द बिगनिंग ऑफ द चैप्टर आई हैड बीन टेलिंग यू, है ना, मैं बता रही हूँ. तो वो कहता है कि सपोज इफ यू आर कंडेम्ड टू डेथ, तुम्हें एग्जीक्यूशन यानी तुम्हें डेथ पेनल्टी मिल जाए और नेक्स्ट डे मेरा ऑपरेशन हो, तो समझ में आया? तो मतलब वो इतना डर गया कि इसकी उसको डेथ सेंटेंस ना दे दिया जाए. और सपोज मेरी तबीयत बिगड़ जाए और मुझे ऑपरेशन की जरूरत पड़ जाए तो फ्रॉम वेयर आई एम गोइंग टू गेट डॉक्टर सदाओ. इसका मतलब डॉक्टर सदाओ शुड बी सेव्ड ऑन एनी कंडीशन, ही शुड बी सेव्ड. ओके, हु डिसाइड्स? दिस जनरल डिसाइड्स. क्लियर?
यस मैम.
ओके बेटा, थैंक यू. देन इट्स 11:10:30. ओके, गॉड ब्लेस यू ऑल.
Thank you, ma'am.
Thank you. God bless you all.